Hello, it's Mr. Rio here to show you how to format paragraphs using the paragraph dialog box in Microsoft Word. Unfortunately, I don't have the Windows version to show you this on, but I'll tell you a little bit where you can find it. When you have the Windows version open, you have the Home tab, okay, like this. Around here in the middle, because it looks a little different than this, there's a section that says paragraph. And there's kind of a weird little arrow thingy down near the edge of the ruler. And you click that to open up the paragraph dialog box. You can look in the other tutorial that I posted for this assignment, the one that's a formal Windows tutorial. And that one is just a little bit helpful, but believe me, my tutorial I'm going to show you here is much more helpful. As long as you can open the paragraph dialog box in Word for Windows, once it's open, it looks just like what I'm about to show you, and it'll be way easier to format these paragraphs and get the two documents here you need to do looking the way you want them to look. Okay, and you can just follow me for guidance here and do the same thing. And basically, you're going to do about the same thing on both documents for the most part. And so we're going to get started. And if that tutorial I share doesn't help you, just Google how to open the paragraph dialog box in Word for Windows, and it should have a few steps somewhere to do that. But from what I remember, it's on the Home tab, and you go to the paragraph area around here, and there's like a little almost hidden arrow in the corner. You click that. I believe that's what opens it. But here on the Mac, it's a little bit different. I think this is a much nicer setup. We have a format menu here, that's where it is right there. It's really nice. But I'm going to leave that. I don't know why the Windows version doesn't look like that. I think it looks way better and works much easier. But needless to say, let's go back to this document. Now, when you first type this document up, just type it left align, nothing fancy. Now, this here, I formatted as I went, just made it a little bigger, all caps, made it bold, but you can come back and do that later. Here we got our three paragraphs and a little subtitle right there. Down here, I got the bibliography made in bold and a little bit bigger, 14 point, and have an italic down here underlined. So, and then we have a header up here, which we've covered before how to do headers, so that should be review. Now we got our three main paragraphs here, and the first one, I don't count this as a paragraph, but technically in Word it is. That's another story. But our three, what we normally think of as a paragraph, the first and the last one are going to be formatted the same. So I'm going to show you a little trick for doing that. The one in the middle is going to be formatted quite a lot different. I'll be showing you how I do that. It's a little bit, a step or two more, but it's still quite easy. So first thing we need to do is select our first paragraph we're going to format. Right now, this is just type, single space, left aligned, nothing fancy. Now, I highlighted it so you can visually see what I got selected. But if you just clicked anywhere in this paragraph, doesn't matter where, Microsoft Word will know, I mean, when you open up the paragraph dialog box, it'll know what paragraph you're talking about. But I'm going to highlight just to visually make it more understandable. Now I'm going to open up the paragraph dialog box. So like I said, on the Mac is a little bit different location. But once you have it open, it's got the same stuff here. On the top, we have alignment. Right now it's on left. Ignore this outline level. We're not going to use that at all. Indentation. The left and the right does the entire paragraph. So for the first paragraph, we'll leave it on zero. We'll be using that in the second paragraph when we indent it. We'll get to that. Now over here under special, if you pull this down, there's a first line indent and a hanging indent. Okay, we want the first line indent. Now by default, it does it for 0.5 of an inch. We want 0.3 of an inch. So click the little down arrow or just type in there 0.3. Either one will work. Okay, so right now, this is still left aligned. No indentation from the left or right of the entire paragraph. We have a first line indent, and we have 0.3 of an inch for our first line indent. Now under spacing, over here where it says line spacing right there, let's change this to 1.5. So it's not quite double. It looks kind of like double space, but it's kind of like a shorter version of double space. We'll do 1.5. Now, what if someone in the class did a double? That's fine. It'd just be a little bigger. I think the 1.5 looks nicer for this assignment. Okay, and that's it. We're not changing anything here. Now, when you start making some of these changes, you'll see a sample down here. So you'll get a feel for what it's going to look like. Okay, so we got left alignment, first line indent 0.3, line spacing 1.5, nothing else has changed. I hit OK. Voila, it's that simple. Now we're going to do the middle paragraph. I'm going to highlight this. And, of course, open up the paragraph dialog box again. Now this is going to be a little different. We're going to start with a first line indent. I'm going there first. And we're going to do 0.3. And so we got a little first line indent. Now we want to indent the entire paragraph. So you could go up to an inch. I'm going to do just slightly under an inch. Okay, I'm going to do about 0.8 on each side. 0.8 on the left, 0.8 on the right. Now if you want to do a whole inch, go for it. I won't hold it against you. If you want to do 0.9 of an inch, I'm doing 0.8. And I'm going to see what it looks like. I can always come back and change it. I'm going to leave the line spacing as single. And then I'm going to change the alignment. We haven't done this before. To something called justified. What is justified? Well, normally if you have left align, it lines everything neatly on the left. If you have right align, it lines it neatly on the right. If you have center, it just centers it. And we want it to be neat on the left and the right at the same time. Okay, they do that in newspapers and magazines and stuff a lot. So we got justified. I did 0.8. You can do an inch, 0.9, somewhere around there. First line indent, 0.3, and single space. And hit OK. Now that looks pretty close to what's on there. Actually, 0.8 might be almost a little too much. Maybe 0.7 would be a little bit better. Okay. I'm going to highlight this here. I can just click in it. I don't even have to highlight. I'm going to reopen up the paragraph dialog box, and I'm just going to make this 0.7 on both sides and see what it looks like. I think I like that a little better. I'm going to leave that. And now what the, there's something on my computer screen here, but if you see that, but the justified makes it neat on both sides. To do that, it has to adjust spacing between the words. So sometimes you see some bigger gaps between the words when you use justified. Okay, so that's the middle one. And I did the first line indent. I can't remember if the sample you guys got has a first line indent there. Sometimes these type of paragraphs that they pull out for quotes do first line indent. Sometimes they don't. But either way, we did that. Now, cultural musical taste was just simply bold. Other than that, it's the same size. Now, here's a trick. We want this paragraph, the third regular paragraph, formatted the same as this first one up here. Now, I could click in it and open up the paragraph dialog box and do the same settings. Okay, that's one option. But I could click up here, so the cursor's in there, and this thing way up here, it looks like a paintbrush, and I'm sure the Windows version got it somewhere around there too. That's called the Format Painter, or it says here, Copy Formatting. So how this works is like this. You put your cursor where you want to copy, which is this paragraph. You click on that brush, and you drag it across what you want to look the same. So I dragged it across this paragraph. I let go, and there. It does the exact same formatting. Font, size, indentation, first line indent, spacing. It does the same. So there. It was that simple. You type it up, a few clicks with the paragraph dialog box, and it's looking real good. And, of course, do a save and submit it. Then you're going to be doing a second one very similar to this. So this tutorial, I hope, makes it really easy for you. And it should not take you long at all to do these two documents. So good luck.